Boom, shake the room, Fire Nation. JLD here with an audio masterclass that, believe me, trust in me, you are going to want to listen to in its entirety. This will be on the 7 steps to designing the perfect funnel system for your business so that you can capture leads, convert sales, and create a community of raving fans for your business. And to deliver this audio masterclass, I have brought Bryan Dulaney. He has been marketing online since 2006, and he's a CEO and founder of the Perfect Funnel System, which is responsible for generating over $60 million in online revenue for his clients, partners, and his own products and services. Bryan believes that your expertise powered by the right system can change the world. And Fire Nation, Brian's the real deal. He's a friend of mine. He has been for a number of years. We used to live and hang out in San Diego, very close to each other, and he's just a great guy. I was just actually hanging out with him in December of 2018 at an event. He's doing some incredible things, and we have some awesome, awesome value to deliver to you when we get back from thanking our sponsor. So, Bryan, say what's up to Fire Nation and share something interesting about yourself that most people don't know.
What's happening, Fire Nation? Super honored to be here today. And, you know, one thing that a lot of people don't know about me is that I got my second degree black belt in Taekwondo when I was really, really, really little. And so that's a fun fact that I don't really talk about a lot, but it took a lot of dedication to do that and get through that. And it's something that I really cherish and super grateful that I did, because it allowed me to develop the skill sets at a really young age to be focused and disciplined.
Well, that's pretty cool to know. I will say, as I mentioned in the intro to Fire Nation, that you and I have been friends for quite a long time now, many years, especially when we were back in San Diego and in the same zip code and area. But one thing I didn't know was that, and you know, we were just hanging out a couple months ago in SD for an event, and I was busting your chops pretty good. I don't think I would have done it quite to that level had I known that you had this black belt. Well, you know what? I guess I'll just know for next time. But let's, Bryan, kind of move a little bit forward into what we're going to be having a conversation about today, which is the audio masterclass, 7 steps to designing the perfect funnel system for your business so you can capture leads, convert sales, and create a community of raving fans for your business. And Fire Nation, those words that I just said are the steps, the processes that you need to be implementing into your business, into your life, to create that lifestyle, location, financial freedom that we're talking about all the time. So I'm excited to dive into this. Let's start with your origin story. So kind of take us through that so we can kind of get to know you a little bit better as we set up this whole conversation.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks, John. Again, super honored to be here, and I'm super excited for this conversation. And so let me tell you about, you know, how it all started for me back in 2003 when I actually died and I came back to life. And, you know, I woke up in a cold white hospital bed back in 2003 in Slippery Rock, Pennsylvania. And I had 3 doctors rushing to my bedside as they were singing, "He's alive, he's alive." And I'm, you know, dazed and confused back then. I woke up and had no idea where I was. And the head doctor, you know, he leaned over to my bedside and he said to me, "Son, you are a living miracle. You were one shot from death. I called your parents last night and said that you were either going to die or be brain dead for life. And that all I can say is that God, you know, must have a plan and purpose for your life."
And was that a shot of alcohol?
That was several shots of alcohol.
Oh, man. BD.
Oh, man. It was actually a fraternity hazing. And it ended up being about a fifth of vodka in 20 minutes.
That's insane.
Insane, yeah. But you know what? I'm super grateful for that experience because, you know, I realized that I was put here for a purpose. And that was really like my wake-up call to realize that I was probably not hanging around the right people and that I needed to get on a better track for my life. And so what I did is I transferred colleges. And I ended up figuring out my purpose about 2 years later. It was a journey for me, you know. And I realized that my purpose, I discovered that at Liberty University, where I ended up. And I realized that my purpose was to share my story and help other people share their story. But, you know, back in 2005, like, I really had no idea what that meant. It was super fuzzy. And so I was graduating. I graduated from Liberty with a marketing degree. And then because I, you know, didn't want to get a job, I went to work on my MBA in entrepreneurship, you know, while I was trying to figure out what I was going to do to earn a living for myself. And I remember back then, I just wanted to make $10,000 a month, clear $10,000 a month. You know, I wanted to be my own boss. I wanted to travel the world, and I wanted to be able to, like, you know, create life on my terms, right? Create experiences, and that was my desires back then. And so I started learning everything I could about, you know, how to make money online. And I discovered this 30-day challenge. It was about how to make your first dollar online in 30 days. And somehow, by the grace of God, I say, I made $750 in one day from the referral of one sale on a ridiculous, crazy domain name that was super silly at the time, right? It was Fit Rich Life. I mean, how silly is that? But someone happened to stumble upon it, and they happened to click through my link, and they happened to buy. But that's what got me into this whole world of marketing online, and I started as an affiliate. And one thing I knew is having that secondary black on Taekwondo, like, I knew the fastest path was to find a coach or a mentor who had already been where I wanted to be. And so I found this guy out of Australia. He was killing it. He was doing multiple six figures a month with affiliate marketing, and he had clients that were paying him really well. And I bought everything that he had, literally. He had all these, like, back then, this was, you know, 2006. I bought, like, he had $67 products and $97 products. And, you know, it was a different landscape back then, right? And I bought everything. And I'm like, man, I hit him up on Skype. I had a free hour call with him. And I was like, man, if you could just teach me the ropes, like, I'll do anything you tell me to do. And so after enough bugging him, he said, all right, I'll coach you. Here's the terms. And I paid him some money, and he ended up showing me the ropes, which I'm super grateful for, because I went on to promoting an affiliate campaign, spending $500 on pure faith. Literally, I mean, I was in college working on my master's degree, literally leveraging credit cards because I was, you know, it up into my ears in student debt.
Well, how'd you go from there to where you are today? I mean, let's get to that.
Yeah, let's do it. Okay, so what happened was I got really good at selling other people's stuff. And because of the nature of selling other people's stuff and making commissions, what happened was people started saying, oh, can you do that for me? Oh, can you do that for me? And so it kind of just snowballed. I found this water ionizer product that I wanted to promote as an affiliate. And I contacted this company and said, hey, can I promote your water ionizer, you know, and you send me commissions? And they're like, oh yeah, you can buy them for $1,000 and you can sell them for $2. And I'm like, oh no, I don't want to do that. Let me just send you some buyers and you pay me a commission. And the guy, you know, he was kind of baffled by it. And he's like, well, we don't have that in place, but we'd love for you to do our marketing for us and help us dominate our market. And so he was my first client. Like, that's what got me in the door. And then from there, kind of just snowballed to where we are today, really, where we, you know, promote and sell other people's stuff as affiliates, and also, you know, help other people with their marketing and their advertising and their funnels and all that type of fun stuff.
So what I love is that you've developed these steps, and there are 7 steps. And what he helps people do, Fire Nation, and again, I've seen this happen, and I've seen him present this full entire chat from a stage before, is this perfect funnel system so that you can capture those leads, convert those sales, and obviously create a community around that of raving fans, which is so tough to do. But once you do it, it's such a valuable asset because you can go in so many different directions from that point. So let's just start off by talking about those two deadly and also invisible forces. So that's a bad combination. They're deadly and they're invisible, Fire Nation, but they're plaguing so many entrepreneurs today. So I want to talk about those two, Bryan. And then, of course, how do we eradicate them?
Yeah, absolutely. There's two deadly invisible forces that I kept seeing come up with entrepreneurs that I was helping and also their students. So it's a bit of a universal problem that we all have to overcome. And that's, number one is shiny object syndrome. I mean, man, I can't tell you how easily it is to get distracted these days, right? There's so many new offers and there's new marketers and there's all types of new experts that are, you know, teaching some new hack and tactic these days, right? So that was the first problem. It was keeping people focused and avoiding shiny object syndrome. So that's number one. And the way to eradicate shiny object syndrome is to create a plan that's specific to you and your business and the goals and desires that you have for your life, and then just blocking out all the distractions, right? So that's the first one, shiny object syndrome. And it takes too many people out, and I hate when I see it. It just bothers me. The other one is lone wolfing it. That was another problem I kept seeing come up time and time again. And, you know, lone wolfing it is a dangerous, I mean, men, we like to go to the man cave, right? We like to do that. That's something that we do, right? women are a little better at it than men. They understand the value of like community, right? But us men, we like to lone wolf, and I've certainly, you know, had my fair share of lone wolf in it myself. And the way that I believe to eradicate lone wolf in it is surrounding yourself with a community, with the right pack, right? Whether that's a mastermind or whether that's a small group. But it's, for me, it's, you know, I'm in masterminds, so I'm able to surround myself with like-minded people that are able to help me up level my game, but not allow me to stay in my own bubble. So that's what I would say are the two deadly invisible forces that are so critical that you eradicate. The sooner the better. Like, I wish I would have heard about that, those two deadly forces sooner, because, man, I don't know about you, John, but, you know, the masterminds that I'm in and the circles of people that I get to bump, you know, bump shoulders with, it's a lot easier to get through things when challenges come up, because it's natural that they will.
So Fire Nation, the lone wolf in it, I love that phrase. You know, don't try to go at this by yourself, because then you're going to make the same mistakes that so many people have made that have come before you. That's why I always say, you know, like, follow the mistakes that I make as much as the successes that I have, so you can avoid those mistakes, you can emulate those successes. Like, there's people that have come before us, we are all standing upon those shoulders of giants. So don't lone wolf it, surround yourself. Why do I end every one of these episodes by saying you're the average of the five people you spend the most time with? So keep hanging out with people like BD and JLD, this, because that's what's going to make you awesome and take you to the next level, by hanging out with the right people and learning from that network. I mean, just hanging out with the five right people isn't just five people, it's the connections and relationships those five people have, which could be 100, 1,000, many, many multiples of that. And that's where it gets exciting. And then, of course, that first point that Bryan made, you've got to focus, Fire Nation. Follow one course until success. Make that happen. So moving through this, Bryan, I want to really kind of have a little bit of a conversation now about different money magnets that people can use to build their list and grow their business. So the thing is, you know, here we are, we have this idea, we have this passion, we have this curiosity, we want to combine it with a skill, an expertise, a value that we can bring to the world. You are really good at this. Let's talk through about how to create, you know, let's say 10 irresistible money magnets that we can actually use to build that list. And let's really buzz through these, because Fire Nation can go back and rewind as they want. And of course, you're going to have something awesome for them to kind of sum all this up at the end as well. But let's really rip through these 10 irresistible money magnets.
Yeah, absolutely. So the first thing that I'd have to say about, you know, when you're creating your irresistible money magnets is there's two things. So having the right bait for the right audience is so important. And I use the example of, you know, if we're fishing for marlin, right, then we don't want to go chumming, right? Because chumming is when you, you know, chop up a bunch of dead fish, they're, you know, put them in a bucket, it gets all bloody, and then you throw it in the back of the boat, right? And if you do that, then, you know, sharks will come, right? Not by the nature of the blood infested water. So you got to have the right bait for the right audience. And so that's a must have. You know, when you're bringing these, your own, you know, lead magnet or money magnet to the market. The other thing that is so important is curiosity. And that's the driving force of it all. And what I like to say about that is you want to run it through a test so that people don't say these words, I already know that, or I already have that, or I've already seen that, right? Because as soon as they say those things in their mind, then they leave, right? So keeping that curiosity factor as high as possible so that they're saying things like, I wonder what that is. I need to have that, right? And the curiosity is strong, and then they'll move into it. And that's where we see conversion rates being able to go from, say, you know, 10, 20% to 30, 40, 50% in some cases, just by changing up some language to create some curiosity. Now, some of the irresistible money magnets that I absolutely love, the first one I would say would be webinars. I know, John, you do a lot of stuff with webinars as well. And like webinars or automated webinars, absolutely love them, because it gives you the opportunity to build a relationship with people and build some trust, which is really important. I mean, you know, especially when it comes to converting sales online, right? Because we're going up against trust being dead, right? And, you know, when you start marketing your money magnets online, you're going to reach people that don't know you yet, right? And so the faster you can warm them up and get them, you know, in relationship with you by providing massive value, and you can do that through a webinar, which is great. And so I would say get really good at doing webinars yourself, because it's gonna benefit you in the long run. So I love webinar funnels. I love automated webinar funnels. Once the webinar funnel is performing at the right rate, right? I see a lot of people try to jump at the gun and just automate right away. And while that's great, your best bet is to do 10, 20 live webinars and get good at it and get your conversion rates to the point where they need to be. And then you can automate.
I have a phrase that I live by, Fire Nation. Sales happen on live webinars. And by the way, you're not going to be good at webinars until you do a ton of them. So do live webinars. I've done them now for 5 years and I have no intention of stopping. It's a great way to improve your speaking skills, all these different things. So I love this, and make sure you make it happen, Fire Nation. You're only going to get better by putting in the reps. So Bryan, pick up the speed here, bro. Yep. Let's rip through these 9 more.
Let's rock and roll. So free challenges. I'm sure you've seen challenges. Challenges are amazing. We've done a lot of great things with those. Checklists are great, because they're quick, they're easy to consume. Free reports, free guides, free samples, toolkits and resource lists, software downloads, free trials, coupon discounts, quizzes, surveys. I mean, all of these are great lead magnets, or what I like to call irresistible money magnets, so you can build your list. Free book or a free plus shipping offer. Those are some different examples that you guys can use that we're using right now that are great ways to build your list, so you can build a relationship with these people and then, you know, eventually convert sales. And our ultimate outcome is to create a community of raving fans, which, John, I love you, what you've done.
Thank you.
In your community, because you really have a true tribe of raving fans, which is what we're all going for, right?
Yeah. And it's by putting in the reps, Fire Nation. I've done this because I've been here for 6 years delivering free episodes, over 2,080, you know, to date. And I'm not stopping anytime soon, because I know the value of what this process is and how to become positioned as a thought leader and category king in your market. And by doing these processes that Bryan's talking about, that's what you're going to do. Now, again, we are kind of ripping through some of these things because we have to, because this is just a audio podcast only interview, but make sure you're sticking around because we're going to have some great stuff for you. In fact, let's do a little teaser right now, Bryan. I know you have a awesome and a unique URL for Fire Nation to go to find out more about everything that we're talking about. So we have a lot more to share with you today, Fire Nation. But real quick, Bryan, tell us a little more about freegoldentickets.com.
Yeah, absolutely, John. So what we've done is we've put our 7-figure and our 8-figure funnels, the emails and the scripts that are behind those funnels, onto a USB drive that we ship all around the world. Literally, I mean, we have these things flying around the world. All we ask is you pay for the shipping and handling so we can ship it all around the world. But on it, we have our 7-figure expert funnels, emails, and scripts. So that's like if you're an author, speaker, coach, or consultant, maybe a purpose-driven entrepreneur who has thought leadership or expertise that you want to bring to the world, those are on there. Our 8-figure agency funnels, emails, and scripts are there as well. So if you're an agency or a freelancer or a service provider, that's the bucket that you would fit into. And so we have our 8-figure funnels on there. And then we have our 7-figure e-commerce funnels, emails, and scripts. So, you know, if you sell physical products, we have our physical product funnels, emails, and scripts loaded onto this free golden ticket as well.
So Fire Nation, simple process, freegoldentickets.com. Jump on there, check it out, get it out to you. And real quick, Bryan, and again, just in a couple words, couple sentences, like why did you go the actual route of putting it on a thumb drive and shipping it? What's the process behind that?
The reason why we did that is because I wanted to create something that we could ship out. And I wanted to create a fun campaign that brought more creativity to the market. And because, you know, over the years, I've been doing this for 12 years now. So over the years, you know, it's all about getting original and bringing something new and fresh to the market. And so reason why I put it on a thumb drive is because we kind of model the Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory theme, right?
Yeah.
So I dressed up as full on Willy Wonka, and my wife, Stephanie, she dressed up as an Oompa Loompa, sexy Oompa Loompa. I will have to say myself. So we created this fun thing where there's winners, just like Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, right? There was like, you know, 5 golden tickets. They got the opportunity to come into the to the Chocolate Factory. And so we modeled that in the campaign.
And so there will be golden tickets potentially for those in Fire Nation who order this thumb drive.
That's right. We still have three
more. Get the golden ticket, Fire Nation. Hey, if you get that golden ticket, you better be snapping a photo, tagging me on Instagram or any number of things, because I definitely want to know. So, Bryan, let's move forward, because, you know, a lot of people in Fire Nation, let's be honest, capturing leads is a struggle because it's a very busy world out there. And we do at this date, you know, in 2019 and beyond, you know, we're looking to build lists. We want to provide massive value. We want predictability for our businesses. And of course, we want to be able to scale our businesses, but not just the hard way. We want to scale it the smart way. So, you have five ways that you've considered really great ways to capture leads. So just like we buzzed through those 10 money magnets, let's buzz through these five ways to capture leads.
All right, let's rock. So name and email, like building your own database is still viable. It's still important, right? So name, email, like building your own database. So important. That's the first way of capturing leads that I still recommend that you do today and continue to do into the future. SMS is great if you're at an event. So if you're at an event, we've used SMS to, you know, you've seen it before, I'm sure, right? Text this code to this number and you can get some free stuff, right? That is great. If you have the right thing that you're giving away for free, you can capture over 50% of the room in some cases, depending on how large the room is, of course, and how relevant what you're giving them is. But SMS is a great way to build a list when you're at a live event. What I love, I've been using it lately, is Messenger bot, ManyChat. I mean, the open rates on ManyChat are crazy, upwards of 90%. It's insane. So ManyChat's a great way to build a list on Facebook. So I recommend building a list off of Facebook and on Facebook, just because people are so used to, you know, getting messages on their phone and opening them. Okay, so we've got an opportunity here, I believe, in the next, you know, couple years, really, to take advantage of building a list there. And so that's the third way. Live chat, for many people who have a service-based business or are really support and you know, really support driven, I've found that live chat can be an amazing way to bring your site to life and a way to capture leads as well, right? For all the people that have questions before they buy your products and services. And then remarketing. Oh man, remarketing is an absolute phenomenal way to capture leads and build a list. But what you're doing there is you're building a pixel list. So that way you can follow people around with your advertising. And I'm sure you've seen it. You've been on websites before and then all of a sudden they're now following you with these banners around, and you know that, you know, I'm sure you've seen it. At this point, a lot of people do remarketing. There are basic ways to do remarketing, advanced ways to do remarketing. But I would recommend, if you're not doing remarketing, there's a few platforms that you'll want to tap into. AdRoll.com, Perfect Audience. Google AdWords has remarketing, and Facebook as well. So you definitely Facebook remarketing. And just start building up your pixel list, because you have the opportunity to use banners to get in front of them multiple times a day. I mean, you don't have the opportunity to email 30 times a day, but you do have the opportunity with remarketing to get in front of people and stay in front of them for up to 6 months. It's really one of the most powerful ways of capturing leads and then continuing to be in front of them for a long, long time.
Most people in this world, Fire Nation, are strangers to us. I mean, as big of an audience as I've grown, as much as a quote unquote influencer that, you know, I like to at least think that I've become, I mean, I'm going to walk into a supermarket or I'm going to walk into any store, you know, around the world, and nobody's going to have ever heard of me. I mean, most people are strangers to us and to each other, period. It's just the world that we live in. But it's critical when you're building a business that you are actually developing relationships with people who start off as strangers, but then begin to know, like, and trust you. And then you are doing in the correct way of turning that, like, no trust into leads and customers, so you can get predictability for your business. So it's a process of not being known at all by a certain person or a bunch of people, quote unquote strangers, and then getting those people, those strangers, to know, like, and trust you, and then being able to offer solutions to their biggest problems so that you're able to turn those strangers into leads and then into customers. And then you can have that predictability in your business. So talk about how you developed a system to do just that, Bryan.
Absolutely. So once we have them on a list, we now have the opportunity to provide massive value. Okay. And so that's how I see it. I see it in a way in which when we produce massive value or results in advance. And I like to tell this through a little story of, let's say I created a 5-part video series that's free, right? And I have the topic being how to make your first dollar online as an affiliate without needing to create your own products and, you know, without having to, you know, service customers or without having to house inventory, right? So the topic is very specific. It's for people who want to sell other people's stuff as affiliates, right? And they want to make money online or figure out how to predictably make money online. So we're speaking to a very specific group of people, which is great because when we go to advertise that funnel, we will be able to get in front of the right people, right? So important, right? Having the right bait for the right audience. So what I talk about when I do this illustration is we've got 5 days of videos that they're expecting to be receiving. And so day one, we talk about domain name buying, right? Then the next day we talk about hosting. And so what we're doing is we're just walking them through the process of getting from step A to step B, which is where they are now, not knowing how to make money online, to step B, which is knowing how to make money and how to make that first dollar and make it predictably, right? So we are taking them through the journey. So day one is domain buying, then hosting, then I give them a free affiliate funnel maybe so they don't have to worry about building the funnel themselves, right? Then day four is changing some links and some content. And then after we've done some training, but more importantly, we've also inspired them along the journey as well. Really important critical step that I see a lot of people miss is each day, we don't want to just teach, but we also want to inspire. And it's the balance of inspiration plus training that helps people move along on the journey, right? We don't want to get them stuck in the mud because if we do too much training, then they get stuck in the mud and they feel overwhelmed. Right? So that's an important ingredient. And then day five, once we've built up some trust, we've provided value, we've helped them produce some results. Okay. I mean, literally day four, they could send it out to their list, post it on social media, and they could make money. But the problem is that they don't know how to predictably print money. They don't know how to predictably make money with that funnel that they just built for themselves. And so day five, we do a case study about how we're producing 300% return on ad spend through Facebook ads, right? And we do the same thing. We would have an introduction, we would teach, we would inspire. But then this point, because we've earned the right to make an offer, then we make an offer and we introduce the offer. Maybe it's a Facebook advertising course that shows them how to advertise on Facebook with their new funnel that they now have. Does that make sense?
Making a lot of sense. And Fire Nation, I hope you're really following along with Brian's systems because he's just a systems guy. He's a step-by-step dude. His mind works like my mind. And I'm telling you, it makes it so easy to follow and to execute when you have these systems, when you have these automations, when you have these step-by-step processes that you just follow. And then guess what? The end result that you're looking for happens when you follow this system. And again, we can only talk about so much today, but if you head over to free golden tickets, that's tickets with an S, freegoldentickets.com, you're going to be able to, for a few bucks, get essentially Brian's entire brain, all of his years of experience with his business and his client's business, downloaded onto this thumb drive. You're going to be able to go through and see his genius, his step-by-step systems, his processes. Like, you better believe that I have this thumb drive like plugged into my computer right now because it's gold, period. I mean, speaking of gold, you might get the golden ticket. There's still three left, and wow, that'd be pretty cool. But anyways, we have a lot to talk about, Fire Nation, when we get back from thanking our sponsor. So Brian, we're back, and I really hope, Fire Nation, that you're listening, that you've taken the second to pause, head over to freegoldentickets.com, and just get that thumb drive heading your way no matter where you are in the world, because this is going to be able to take this conversation we're having now to that next level. But let's now talk about increasing the revenue per customer. Because the thing is, Brian, so many entrepreneurs, they just don't see that high return on their investment that they could be seeing because they're not doing a few things. There's such things as bump offers. There's such thing as upsells and downsells. And the problem is people either don't do it or they just do it at the completely wrong time or they do it when it doesn't make sense. So right now, Fire Nation, get ready to tune in because we're going to be talking about how you can increase that total revenue per customer. I mean, this person's already a customer. They've already invested and bought something from you. Now, how can you increase that revenue per customer through these bump offers, upsells, downsells, and then, of course, when it's the right time to make these offers? So, Bryan, take it away.
Yeah, so I like to give this analogy of, you know, when you're at a restaurant, you order a salad, let's say you've ordered a salad, and they come and say, would you like avocado with that? And you're like, sure, yeah, that sounds great. And then later you come to find on the bill, it's $1.75 for that two slivers of avocado, right? That's what an upsell is. And so at this stage of the process, this is step five of a perfect funnel system. And it's at what I call adding outrageous value, because our objective is to generate leads, convert sales, but ultimately the big picture is that we want to create a community of raving fans. So at this point, it's not about just making an offer for making an offer's sake, but it's making an offer that's going to add even more value and help your people on their journey. And so the important thing here is you don't want to scratch the same itch. So what I mean by that is, let's just say that I was selling a course on funnels, and then my upsell, okay, like the how would you like avocado with that, was another course on funnels, okay? It wouldn't really make sense. And then when I looked at the stats after running that campaign, I'd noticed something's off here. What's not working? And the reason why that would not work is because they already feel like they've invested in something to help them build funnels, right? It's kind of like, John, your course on podcasting, if you were to upsell them into another course on podcasting, but just a different title, not as many people would buy it because they feel like they already have that course on podcasting. And so what you want to do is make sure you don't scratch the same itch. So if I'm offering something on funnels on the front end, the upsell would make sense to offer something on traffic and advertising, right? Because that's the next thing that they need. Right? GoDaddy does a great job at this. They have an amazing sequence of offering you all types of other things after you buy a domain name, right? You buy a domain name, now you need email, hosting, business cards. I mean, all types of things that they think you need, but in fact, you might not need them. Apple does a great job at doing what I call bump offers. And they're really just pre-checkout offers, if you will. And Amazon does a really great job at this as well as Apple. Is when you go to buy a new MacBook Pro, right? Apple says, well, would you like to upgrade these features? Would you like to get Apple 365 Care? You know, all of those type of things. But they do it before you check out, right? So that's an example of some companies that do it before you check out. With funnels, you have the opportunity to do some pre-checkout offers. So you, your main offer, right? Then a bump offer where they can just click a button and adds it right to their order. Okay. And that boosts the average cart value, which the average cart value means every person who buys your product, how much is each person who buys your product worth? And the more offers you have in your funnel, and now I only recommend having two upsells, maybe a downsell, but you don't want to go too far out because then it'll just get annoying, right? GoDaddy borderline annoying, right? So we don't want to be that. We don't want to be annoying. We want to be helpful and resourceful. But that average cart value, we're always looking to get that value up. And the reason is so we can spend money to acquire new customers. Right. So you want to look at that. And that's a little techie, but it's something that is important when you're looking to increase the customer value through your funnels.
So Fire Nation, you've already accomplished the most difficult thing, and that is to turn a lead into an actual customer who's invested in you, in your products and services and or communities. Now you add these processes, these bump offers, these upsells, these downsells to maximize that process. So with all of this, Bryan, of course, the key is deliver awesomeness. We, Fire Nation, need to be focused on delivering awesomeness, because if we're doing that, guess what? People are going to become evangelists. You're going to have that wow effect. You're going to turn your new customers into raving fans, which is critical. Quick example on how I try to do this, and sometimes and oftentimes very successful doing this. Somebody joins Podcasters Paradise. Guess what? I immediately, within 24 hours, often within 2 or 3 hours, send them a live video. It's from me saying, Hey, Bryan, it's JLD here. Just want to say thank you for joining Podcasters Paradise, for putting your faith and your trust in Kate and myself. We won't let you down. And Bryan, by the way, I'm proud of you for investing in yourself to share that voice, that message, that mission with the world. Like, it's going to be awesome. And Bryan, make sure you jump in the Facebook group, because myself and Kate were in there every single day answering questions and providing support and guidance. So I'll see you there. Now, that's a personalized video that I take the time out of my day to create for every single person that joins Paradise right away, so that they're like, wow, I honestly now feel like I made the right decision, because John is, he's here, he's engaged, and he's there for me. And then guess what? I also send them an email 2 days later that says, hey, by the way, can I give you a quick call? It's totally optional, but I'd love to call you just to welcome you to Paradise and just to thank you voice to voice. And so after Bryan and I get off this call today, I'm actually literally going to be calling about 20 Paradisers, one by one by one. And I make it very upfront that it's going to be a 1 minute call. Like, it's just a welcome and a thank you for joining. But I take the time every single week to do that. And these are ways that I work to really wow my audience. And so what happens then? They tell their friends, they tell their family, they snap pictures on Instagram, and they tag me, and they post, and they talk about it in the Facebook group. I just got off a call with JLD. That was so cool, and this and that and that. That's what you need to create Fire Nation, because your customers are critical. So deliver awesomeness to them. So Bryan, you have 5 ways that you produce the wow effect. So kind of break it down for us.
Oh, love that, John. So you actually, that is exact. There's 2 of those ways cool. You do in there. So we call customers too. And it's like shocking to them. Right? Even people who spend $9.95, which sounds crazy, right? But we give them a call. It's a real call from a real human being. It's not automated. And we call people and we welcome them. And we say thank you, jump into the Facebook group. And it is mind-blowing, the feedback that produces.
Huge.
Absolutely amazing. Yeah. The other thing we do is I record, actually, similar to what you do, this welcome video when they make an investment in, say, a $1,000 course or a $1,500 course or something along that line. We also do the same thing. So I'll record a short 3 to 5 minute video welcoming them to the community, getting them into the Facebook group. And actually, I've done some research on this within my own client pool. I've seen groups of Facebook groups where people will have, some of my clients have thousands of members that pay $1,000 or more for their products, and they don't do that step.
It's crazy.
And I have my own group of people that we do that for, and we get about 75 to 85% adoption of people that actually will go into the Facebook group and introduce themselves, because I believe because of that welcome call and because of that welcome video.
Totally.
And they felt safe to do it, right? So those are 2 ways that I would encourage you to do, because no one's really doing it. And it's a way to set yourself apart, and it's a way to really show that you care. And I think that goes a long way in producing really that person who can become a raving fan for your business, right? So some other ways that we do, I like to ship welcome packages with t-shirts and swag with the tribe name on it. So we have a group, a tribe community with the name Funnel Boss. And so we ship out these shirts and it says Funnel Boss on them. And what's cool is when you're at events and you actually see people walking around with your shirts on, right, John? I mean, you have that happen all the time, right?
Love it.
And it's awesome, right? And they're wearing that shirt and they're embodying a new identity, which we'll talk about here next in creating your own tribe, is creating an identity that they can stand on that's strong and elevates their game. And so shipping them a welcome package with a nice letter, maybe some swag or a wristband or just something that they can wear, they love it. And it's amazing to see. They post photos with the shirts and the swag. And I had a client of mine. There was a picture. This was amazing. So this guy just had him and his wife. She just had a baby. They had the t-shirt on, and he said, "I just want to let everyone know, as my son was born, we said to my son, we are a family that will rise up and live free." And that's the slogan of his brand. And it was just so cool that he actually took the time, wore the shirt. The being a part of the community meant so much to him, and it was directly tied to freedom. And that was something that he was going to, the value system that he was going to bring to his son. Absolutely incredible.
So Fire Nation, this is the process that you need to be going through, again, to wow, to go one step beyond. And I mean, Bryan and myself, we're two of a very, very few people that take this many steps to show our customers how much they mean to us. So take it home, Bryan, and then bring us right into the building and creating a tribe of raving fans, how to do that.
Perfect. Yeah. So the other thing we do is giving extra bonuses that we didn't mention, right? So we'll do a webinar. Maybe we talk about they're going to get 10 things and then we just over deliver, right? And we give them 15 or 20. And just, you know, part of that element of delivering awesomeness is creating that wow effect. And that's what we want firing in their minds is wow, wow, I can't believe, wow. Like, and that's what we're going for, right? And what the beautiful thing about creating your own version of the perfect funnel system for your business is that we get to create it. It's something that we get to, you know, it's like we all have our own unique fingerprint. And so you get to create this for yourself and for your tribe and your community. And so that's another thing that you can do. And I want you to be, you know, carefully thinking through this question is how can you create that wow effect for everyone who becomes a new customer in your business, right? And think through it and then put it into place and watch as the magic happens. It's really amazing. So the seventh step of a perfect funnel system is building a tribe of raving fans, okay? So this is all about getting people from the stage of just purchasing your products or services to actually sharing your products and services with others, maybe sharing your message with others, with their friends, their family, their social media profiles, all that stuff, right? And they viralize your brand, right? And so what we like to do is, first off, create a tribe name. I mean, over the years, I've seen, you know, doing this for 12 years, you see people come and you see people go. And the people who stick around, what I've noticed is that they have created a tribe for their community and a new identity, okay? Funnel Boss, I mentioned, that's an example. That is someone who sells funnels without ever having to build a funnel themselves. So that's an example of a tribe community name that we've created. Lion Chasers is another one that we've created. It's a mastermind of men where we get together, you know, 8 times a year. And it's about creating this community of mighty men who go after their dreams and their goals with boldness, just like Benaiah did. Who went into the pit with a lion on a snowy day and killed the lion and then became one of David's mighty men, right? So creating your own tribe name and then an identity around it, right? So an identity that they can get behind, that they can declare, right? When people wear your swag, let's say Lion Chasers, for example, they're embodying what it means to be a lion chaser. And so they're more mindful of that as they go through their day, right? So also, another part of the whole raving fan thing is creating your own unique language to your brand, right? And so you've noticed a few different points of language that I've used today, right? Irresistible money magnets or delivering awesomeness or adding outrageous value, right? So you want to start to create, part of creating your own tribe is creating your own language, okay? And then I would also encourage you to set up an affiliate program. Make it easy for your customers to send you new business. I mean, there's nothing better than having a army of affiliates that can drive traffic to your funnels without you have to spending any money. And I remember in 2012, I did this. I put an affiliate program to a service that we launched and it went crazy. We went from zero to 70,000 a month. It was just bonkers. And it was the first time that I had something of my own that just went viral. And the reason why it went viral was because I had one affiliate that found my site through the search engines because of some blog posts that I was doing. Blog posts are not dead. They're still viable ways of generating traffic. And so I did some blog posts. This guy found my site. He hit us up on live chat. Remember, live chat's a great way to engage with your prospects and your buyers. And so he contacted us. He says, "Hey, if this does what it says it's going to do and produces results, I'll get behind it and I'll do a review." And I said, "Okay, great. Like, sign up like a normal customer would, go through the experience, and if it produces amazing results, then great." And it did. He called me back about 2 weeks later, and he said, "Bryan, my rankings, they all went up." And then he documented the whole process. And so he did a review, He sent an email to his list, and he was the primary driving force behind that business going from zero scratch to $70,000 a month. And it was amazing, but it was all because we had one customer who became a raving fan because of the results that he was experiencing. And then he got behind it and just promoted it to everyone on his list.
Fire Nation, that is step 7 of this 7-step process. I mean, that's what Bryan and I have been doing through. We've been going through his 7-step process, which is killer. And again, it's just there for you to go through, to follow, so you can design that perfect funnel system for both you and your business, capture those leads, convert those sales, and create a community of absolute raving fans for your business. So, Bryan, wrap this up for us. Take this home. I'd like to end with a key takeaway that you will just kind of want to really get out there to Fire Nation and say, hey, if there's one thing that I want to make sure the Fire Nation gets from our entire conversation, this is it. Bring this home for us, brother. Let's do it.
Okay, so this is what I really like to leave you guys with. There are only two things that matter that you should be laser focused on right now to launch or scale your business, and that's creating one perfect offer that provides massive value and results for others. So if you're an agency, that means a service that actually produces results for your clients, right? If you're an expert, that means creating products and programs that improve people's lives when they put it into practice. Or if you're an e-commerce store, that means the product that adds value to people's lives. So that's number one. And number two is creating one everlasting funnel, you know, a funnel that can last the test of time. Okay. A funnel like we've mentioned in the Irresistible Money Magnet section of today's conversation. And here's the 5 steps, okay, that you should follow. So define that one perfect offer, map out a funnel for your business, drive some traffic, whether it's paid or affiliates, sell those products and services through live or automated webinars, a great way, and then ascend people up your value ladder of other products and services that they need on their journey to being successful.
Fire Nation, you're going to try to confuse things and just make things more difficult than they have to be. Don't. Just follow this process. You know, to break it down to those two key things, create one perfect offer and create one everlasting funnel. Just do that. And you can make that all happen a lot easier by heading over to freegoldentickets.com. Freegoldentickets.com. Bryan, end here by just kind of giving a little more detail about what's going to happen when they go to freegoldentickets.com, what it means if they get one of those 3 remaining gold tickets, and then we'll say goodbye.
Awesome, man. Yeah, thank you, John. So if you go to freegoldentickets.com, when you head over there, you'll have the opportunity to grab our USB drive that's loaded with our 7-figure and our 8-figure funnels, emails, and scripts. And it doesn't matter what business you're in, because you'll be able to see what's responsible for generating to the tune of 7 and 8 figures across multiple industries. Okay. And it's our gift to you for free. All we ask is that you pay for the shipping and handling fee, and we ship it anywhere in the world. Literally, we have these things flying around the world right now. And so grab a free golden ticket. When you grab one, we will send it to you in the mail. This is something that we ship out. Okay. You'll get it in the mail. And we have 3 of these winning golden tickets left, which means that if you are a holder of one of the winning tickets, you get to spend an entire day with my team and I in what I call the Profit Factory, where we sit down and we map out the perfect funnel system for you, your business. We map out what's the fastest path for you to bring your expertise to the world. What's the fastest path for you to create that perfect funnel system for your business, so you can avoid shiny object syndrome, so you can avoid lone wolfing it, and you can get on the fastest path that's specific for you.
I love it. I'm actually over the page right now, Fire Nation. And let me tell you, Bryan looks a little eerily like Gene Wilder. Like, it's a little creepy, Fire Nation. So definitely get over there. He's got the top hat. He's got the purple jacket on. He's got the whole 9 yards. So you're going to want to get over, check that video out, go through the page. It breaks down everything you're going to get, you know, for just a few bucks again, and get that thumb drive shipped off to you over at freegoldentickets.com. So definitely get over there, get this in your doorstep, because you know this, Fire Nation, you're the average of those 5 people you spend the most time with, and you have been hanging out with BD and JLD today. So keep up the heat. And as always, if you head over to eofire.com and just type Bryan, B-R-Y-A-N, the show notes page will pop up with everything that we've been talking about today, all the links to all the jazz. But the one key link, the one call to action you need to remember is freegoldentickets.com. Get that headed out your way. Get Bryan's brain, his genius, his experience, his expertise headed to your doorstep. Use it to explode into 2019, 2020, whichever year you're listening to this and beyond. Make it happen for you, Fire Nation. And Bryan, I want to say thank you, brother, for sharing your genius with Fire Nation today. So for that, we salute you and we'll catch you on the flip side. All right, Fire Nation. Today's value bombs were brought to you by Bryan Dulaney. He just brought the heat. So thanks for that, Bryan. And of course, freegoldentickets.com, Fire Nation. I hope that you take advantage of these incredible offers because this is how you're going to get to where you need to be by standing upon the shoulders of those who have come before us. I do it. I'm always in that learning mode. So I will see you there or I'll catch you on the flip side.